Yeah, we're just focusing on improving and getting better. Certainly, we have a large group of players returning and getting the freshmen acclimated to our style of play and our system, and getting them involved with the culture of the program. Those have all been our main targets. It's preseason. We know we have a long journey ahead of us, and we're just working hard on getting better and improving, and I think we've done a good job of that so far.
I feel like most of the freshmen and the newcomers coming in have all adapted really well just on themselves. They've all mixed in with the boys. The boys help. The boys, we eat together every day. We train together. We spend most of the days together for the last 2 weeks. And the freshmen have done their part to open up, sit on the tables, get straight in, mix about, and opened up instantly, and we all got to know them really well. Yeah.
And looking ahead now as we go to the regular season, we'll start off with, you know, BC tomorrow. What have you guys really been focusing on as you guys prepare for the Eagles?
We're focused on Quinnipiac. We're focusing on ourselves, and certainly we understand that BC is going to be a big test, and we've played them almost every year regularly for the last 10 or so years, and you know, Coach Kelly does a fantastic job with this program up there, and we always want to test ourselves against the best teams in the country, and we're lucky enough that BC's in our backyard, and that we have that relationship to play them. So, you know, focused on us, we want to get better, as I'm sure BC's focused on themselves, and at the end of the day, I think we will have a good competitive game, and hopefully both teams and both coaches get what they want out of it.
We've had a tough 2 weeks, lots of training, lots of fitness and stuff, and now we're ready to get going. Coach is really nice. Coach is the best coach in the MAC. No, so we've trained hard the last 2 weeks, got ready, and two good pre-season games, getting lots of people in different positions, trying different formations, different tactics, and we're ready to go tomorrow, first game. Instant rivalry, yeah. Well, for me and most of the internationals on the team, it's just another game. Firstly, we've got to focus on Boston, get rid of them sort of thing, beat them, hopefully put in a good performance, and then we'll start focusing on the UConn game.
Yeah, we've been fortunate enough to play UConn almost regularly in the last 5 years or so, and obviously in 2013 when we were lucky enough to play in the NCAA tournament, we paired up against them, and again, Coach Reed and UConn have sort of been the gold standard of soccer in Connecticut for sure, and maybe even in the region. So we've always looked at that program as a benchmark of what we want to do and how we want to grow, and to have the ability to compete with them on the field and see where we measure up and see where we're doing things well and what we need to continue to improve on is always a bonus for us. And again, we're going to go into that game and try to be as competitive as we can and put a good show on the field and see where we are and move forward from there.
Thank you, Coach.
Hey, it's been great. James, Will, Maxie, and all the rest of the senior class have been obviously extremely welcoming of every new player that enters our program, and that's the culture of our team and our group. We don't really classify by age. Certainly new guys come in and they're rookies and they're new and they're trying to make the adjustment, and it's the job of all of us as a team, as a staff. Whether you're a sophomore, junior, senior, it's your job to get the young guys acclimated and welcome them to that family. And all the guys have done a really good job of that. You know, he brings more than that. You know, James is a complete player in the regard that, you know, he can provide us some offensive punch, and at the same time, he gives us defensive stability as well. The biggest thing with James, he's a good communicator on the field. He's an experienced player. So as coaches, you always want players on the field who can sort of embody your ideas and your thoughts and be able to communicate that in a match, because once the whistle blows, we don't have a lot of control. So we need guys on the field who can deliver that message, and we're fortunate enough to have a few of those, and James is one of them.
Last season, I feel like I just came back from an injury, and I was just getting back into it. This year, I had the chance to play over the summer and sort of build up a level of fitness coming in and some game fitness and stuff, and get some games in 90 minutes under my belt, and now I'm back and I'm ready for this season to go.
So obviously it's helped the team a lot last year that James came back towards the end of the season for the most important games, as you want to say. And obviously now that we have everybody fit on board, including him, we have a great team spirit, and we're very cohesive as a team. Obviously, he's going to help us as a leader as well. Oh, especially off the pitch, he's doing a lot of stuff to keep the team together, bring everybody together. And we did a lot of team activities during preseason too. But most of the team players were already here, so we already had a chance last spring to bring everybody closer together and build that family culture, I want to say.